Welcome to my channel. Today we are gonna discuss about some more string methods. In previous video we have discussed string methods. Today we are gonna discuss some more about string methods. So let's get started. So the first method we have is lstrip method. So if I write a name is equals to Umair, but in left side accidentally user presses some gap here. So how can I remove this unnecessary gap? So here is the method we can use to remove this left side gap. So we can use it name dot lstrip. This l means left. It removes the space of the left side. So if I run it, you can see the space of the left side has been removed. So what if I don't use lstrip method and just print it? You can see in printing this name is present here. Okay, if I run it, you can see here there is unnecessary gap. So this method helps us to remove unnecessary gap in left side. So here is another method we have if we have unnecessary gap in right side. So here is in right side there are some unnecessary gap. So instead of L we can use R. So R means right side. So if I uncomment it and run it, you can see here there is no gap. Okay, now what we there are two methods we can left and right space. So what if we have space on both side, just like here, yeah, and here. So you can see in left side and right side both have unnecessary space. So how can we remove this space? We can remove it by simple strip method name dot lstrip. So we can use just it is for both left side and right side. So if I run it, you can see the unnecessary gap is removed. So here is another method called replace method. This method is very important. We will use it multiple times. Okay, so if I write here same example, we can use F, but I use a comma here. So accidentally if I use a comma here, so how can I, instead of comma, if I use something else, so how can I use it? Suppose I don't write M here, so instead of comma I want to write M here. So I can use replace method. I want to replace comma with M, so I can do it by print name dot replace. So I can do it by comma is replaced by M. So here you can see if I run it, so the comma is replaced by M. You can see here, so the comma here is replaced by M. So we can replace anything by using replace method. Here is another example of replace method we can use. So I write a sentence is equals to he is very sorry, I have to use inverted commas here. Okay, he is very. So if I want, instead of space I want a explanation mark here. So how can I, how we can replace space also by using the same method. So sentence dot replace, we can use replace here by comma gap. Sorry, in inverted comma the gap should be replaced by here. So if I use this symbol, so instead of gap, this mark will appear. So if I turn it, you can see here the gap is removed by this explanation mark. So we can replace anything by using replace method. So here is another method we can use. It is also a very important method we will use multiple time in our when we make GUI application. So find method. Find is very useful method. We can use it to find the position of any alphabet or even the whole character. So if I use the same example, he is very handsome, and enter it. So if I want to find the position of something, just like I want to find the position of this is. So how can I find the position of index number of is? The find method is helpful. So sentence dot find, here I am using is, sorry, I have to use inverted comma, is also a statement here. So if I run it, here is 3. He is in, H is in 0, 1, gap is in 2, and is in 3rd position. Here we can find the index number of is in this particular sentence. So even we can find the position of a particular alphabet if we want to of a V, where this V is exist. So I can also do this V. If I shift enter it, you can see in position 6. So here is another, it is if in position 6 we know that we can produce it by 2, it starts from 2 position. If I write 2 here, so it starts from E here or gap here. Okay, if I want to, instead of 2, if I write 3 here, so it starts from 3, it means I. It starts from I and counts from I, that where is the, where is V, and as it finds V, it prints its index number. So if I run it, you can see 6. So this time it counts it starts counting with position 3. So this is all about today. If you like this video, please don't forget to subscribe our channel, and if you really want to learn Python programming language, you can subscribe our channel. We daily upload videos for Python. Hit the like button, and thank you for watching my video.